everybody, how are you doing? I unboxed this guitar, the Harley Benton Fusion Pro HSH-MN in charcoal. I unboxed this guitar in the German video already. So we are already in the middle of the video, I must say, here right now a little bit. And I already got rid of this retainer bar here. There was a string retainer bar here on top, and I couldn't shoot the video with it. The guitar goes constantly out of tune. Heavy quilted maple veneer. This is just the veneer, so we got no 3D look, okay? It looks fine right now, and it looks fine in person, but don't expect, you know, this deep waves or something. No. That's not what you get here, of course. Okay, we got a mahogany body with the fake binding. So this is still the mahogany. It looks like a top, but it's still the mahogany. We got a belly cut here. This is nice. And this guitar, you know, no neck dive. Very comfortable. 3.2 kilogram, this guitar. So pretty light. We got a volume pot, tone pot, and a mini switch. This mini switch is to split these Roswell Ornico 5 pickups. And if you split it, you got always the coil facing the outside. So on the neck humbucker, it's facing the neck. And on the bridge pickup, it's facing the bridge. Okay? The coils on the outside. We got one piece maple neck with a glued on maple fretboard. Very cleanly made. And this fretboard is also high gloss. Lacquered, high gloss. Super nice, feels very smooth. And we got the stainless steel frets here. Mirror shine, rounded on the fret edges. Rounded fret edges. And yeah, everything very smooth. We got a new bone nut. So that's artificial bone and something like graphite in there. I think they already knew that they had problems with this guitar, with the tuning. So they hoped, oh, let's do some graphite in there and maybe it will work better. But no, you have to get rid of this bar here, the string retainer bar. Okay, we got locking tuners and they work okay. They feel don't very good. Sometimes you turn and turn and turn, nothing happens, and then boop, boop, you jump from E to F or something. Tunable guitar and yeah, locking tuners are of course fine. The Harley Benton Fusion Pros here got serial numbers. That's not usual stuff on Harley Bentons. They started it, if I'm not wrong, with the Fusion Pros now. Made in Indonesia guitars. Also the first Harley Bentons, if I'm not wrong, made in Indonesia. And you can see the quality. Made in Indonesia is my new Made in Japan. And the quality is really there. It's fine. We got some edges. maybe here inside this little cavity here, where we got the wheel, we got a little wheel for the truss rod, and there comes a tool with this guitar you can put in one of the holes and turn easily the wheel. But this little cavity is not super clean, you know? There are some rough edges. But honestly, that's a little thing you got here, yeah. But otherwise, there are no problems. The Wilkinson WVS-52K tram. A good tram. I saw this tram on higher price guitars also. I opened already the cavity for you here on the back side, and we can see this tram works with this black, you know, this black block. And I don't know, I really don't know what Wilkinson is using there. I saw this on other Wilkinson trams too, and something I realized very fast is that you cannot hear the springs when you play the guitar. You know, on a Fender Strat or something, you play the guitar and you can hear the springs afterwards. Bing, bing, bing or something. But on these guitars, silencio. Always. They are always silent. And this tram got absolutely no springs here. So there's nothing that could make noises. Everything feels very solid and the guitar stays in tune. The guitar stays in tune after you got rid of this retainer bar here. So this is shielded here too, okay? And inside here, we got big alpha pots. Can you see this here? Big alpha pots, 500K alpha pots. This looks, everything in here looks pretty good. They use some lacquer, you know, shielding lacquer. Is this the right word? In there, black lacquer. So I cannot say so much bad about it. But yeah, the retainer bar and these pickups. The retainer bar is absolutely no go. That's a catastrophic event. that's really a problem. You have to get rid of it in the first minute. I was really frustrated. I shot this video yesterday And I got really frustrated and I stopped the recording and started today on Tuesday again after I got rid of the retainer bar and so on. And now it's a good guitar and maybe these pickups. If I would give here stars, you know, I would give here 6 out of 10 stars. Something is missing. These are not pickups for me. I miss something. They can do everything a little bit, but not everything very good. In my opinion, just in my opinion, okay? And honestly, I don't want to annoy you more with my talking. I think that's it here already. I love the look of the guitar. I love the feel of the guitar. I'm sorry if I cannot explain it really good here. But it's so smooth to play and to bend. And the neck feels, it's perfect for my hands here. And I can reach the last fret and everything feels high quality. It feels high quality. In my opinion, the guitar got more potential with better pickups. And that's my final words here in this video. Okay, I hope you liked it. Today here, talking without green screen. And yeah, have a nice day. And we will see us in the next Halliburton Fusion Pro video with Floyd Rose. Bye bye.